Thank God. My dearly beloved people, I am glad to meet you once again on this TV. Now, I have come to stand before you with a message that has been given by our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, so that I am going to start this message. Let us pray. My dearly beloved Heavenly Father, I thank Thee for Thy loving kindness. Father, since my birth You have protected me in Thy gracious hands till this moment. I thank Thee with all my heart. Father, now I have stood before You to preach Thy word that Thou hast given unto me. Bless this message to help so many people spiritually, and let us all live for the name of Thy Holy and Everlasting One. Father, I thank Thee, kindly remember me and let me speak to the people in Thy name, asking in the name of Lord Jesus, our beloved Savior. Amen. My dear people, today I have brought this message to share with you. This message is being delivered from the Jehovah Jireh Church, Singaraikonda, cell number 970-533-7645. For the last 3.5 years, our beloved Lord was so kind to continue these messages. I do hope that so many souls may be turned to Lord Jesus on hearing the word of God. So now the title of this message is, "Ye shall be hated of all men for my name's sake." This is the thing that spoke by God in Matthew 10:22. Lord Jesus Himself told this thing. What is that? "Ye shall be hated of all men for my name's sake." Why? Why we are hated by all men? Because Lord Jesus already told in John 15:18, saying, "If the world hate you, you know that it hated me before it hated you." This is the thing that was told by our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. If the world hate you, ye know that it hated me before it hated you. Dear people, why the world hated Lord Jesus? Answer is given in John 8:40. What is it? Because Jesus told truth. Jesus told truth. See the following words. John 8:40 says, "Now ye seek to kill me. Now ye seek to kill me, a man that hath told you the truth." This is the thing Lord Jesus says. In John 8:40 he says, "Ye seek to kill me, a man that hath told you the truth." This is the reason for hating Lord Jesus. Why? Because truth saying has become a sin in the sight of the worldly people. In the sight of the worldly people, all truth sayers are an abomination to them. So, who know not the holy and living God? So many people, they don't know the holy and living God. They follow lies. They love lies. Because the reason to hate Jesus is He Himself is truth. Lord Jesus, He Himself is truth. According to 1 John 1:5, God is light, and in Him no darkness at all. And in Him no darkness at all. The world loves not truth, but lies. The world loves not truth, but lies. Because they love their father, and the lusts of their father they will do. He, the devil, was a murderer from the beginning and abode not in the truth, because there is no truth in him. In whom? In Satan. When he speaketh a lie, he speaketh of his own. For he is a liar and the father of it, that means the liar was born first. After his birth, lie has come into existence. Who is that liar? Satan. So, from the very beginning, human race, majority of the living people love lies, but not truth. All liars always hate the truth sayers, because all liars belong to their father, the devil. But all the truth sayers are of God. So, the entire population of the world is divided into two main groups. First one, Lord's children. Second one, Satan's children. So both of these are enemies to each other. Mostly, satanic people love not the people of God. Why? Because satanic people love lies always. But godly people hate lies. They speak truth. Why? Because their Heavenly Father, Jesus Himself is truth. So all truth sayers belong to the Heavenly Father, because Lord Jesus says in John 14:6, I'm the truth. So generally there takes place enmity between satanic and godly people. So the enemy Satan tries at his might to wipe out all the godly children from the face of the earth. Dear people, he tries it at its might from the very beginning to wipe out all the truth sayers. It knows well it could not do. But the Satan tries every moment to attack the godly children. If it is possible, it tries to kill them as it likes. So Satan, at no reason, it always tries to kill them. That means kill all the godly children by its brutal acts. Out of all the godly children from the face of the earth, it wants to exalt Himself over the children of God. Why? Because its nature is cruel. He never likes God's children who are living their lives as sheep. Sheep does not hurt anybody. Why? Because he has no any kind of protecting things like horns or beating or kicking something else. It cannot do. It is most humble and most loving one. It does not harm to anybody from its birth to death. Like that, the children of God who repented at their lives and confessed their sins before the living God, they live their sinful life. Before their transformation, they too are filled with some sort of satanic lives, satanic habits, to take revenge on others also. But when a man or a woman comes to understand that she or he is not dear to the Holy God, when a person understands that, lives in his heart, on hearing the word of God, God blesses them to understand that state. When a person understands that state, immediately he or she kneels down before the living God, begging for his pardon. Whoever begs for the pardon of themselves, very kind Savior, who prepared himself to die on the cross for all the sinners, he is ready always to wipe out all the tears of the humble people who humbly request him for pardon. So, my dear people, we must understand and carefully try to know the reality. Children of God, they pray for the enemy also, but the satanic people, they never find peace in their lives because their lives are filled with hatred. They don't know the real meaning of love. What is love? Love is the nature that never harms to anybody. Even though a person brutally behaves at him or her, they weep before the Lord for them. Father, kindly pardon them. They know not you. They know not the reality. They know not the purity. They know not love. So their hearts are always filled with hatred and enmity. With no curse, they always awaiting to destroy the godly people with no reason. Why? Because their nature is that. How they continue like that? Because they don't want to hear the word of God. They don't want to allow the word of God into their hearts. They know not from where they come to this world. And after that, and after their lives are end, they don't know where they have to be. So, to say in one word, they don't know from where they have come, and after their lives are end in this earth, they don't know where they have to go. If these two things are taken into their thinking, trying to understand them, they really come to the feet of Lord Jesus or the Word of God, the Bible, which declares that a man who lives on the face of the earth, he shall die on one day or other. Why? Because God put his soul in the heart of a man that belongs to the Creator, Jesus. After the particular period of time is over on the face of the earth, automatically he has to return to that place where he comes from. What happens then? While he was on the face of the earth, if he could come to know the reality and repents for his faults and wrongdoings, and if any time begs for the pardon, he will automatically be remembered by the God. Why? Because God declares that he who comes to me with a humble heart, I'll pardon him certainly. I cannot remember his sins or her sins, what kind of sins they may be. When he comes to me or she comes to me with all the burdens of their sins, if they beg me for pardon, I'm so kind to wipe out all their iniquities, all their sins. I'll wipe out all their sins with my blood that was shed on the cross for all the sinners. So, very particularly, all human beings must understand that by birth they are sinners. Why? Because one may take it for consideration or not, the Word of God says the very first man, Adam, lived on the face of the earth. The living God made Adam with his own hands from the earth. And then he gave a woman named Eve for his happiness as a friend and life partner. So both of them were living on the face of the earth happily. But one day, Satan went to them and spoke lies with them and tempted them. And it could made them to violate the orders of the living God Jehovah. As a result of that, Adam became a sinner. Each and every human being who lives on the face of the earth, even today, became sinners in the sight of God. Why? Because of the violation of his orders that were delivered to Adam. So, my dear people, we have to remember this thing first of all. We have to believe it. Whether you believe it or not, this is true. God created you. So you are taken out of the earth, and after that you have to return to the earth. But mean the soul in your heart that belongs to the Creator. The Creator is holy. He is the truth himself. By violating the orders of Jehovah, all the people who violate that orders have become sinners and enemies to God. So, it is our responsibility nowadays, whether he may be a king or a man who doesn't care by anybody, he has to return to the eternity. Eternity, first one is heaven and the other one is hell. Everybody knows it well. All religions of this world accepts this fact. There is heaven and hell. All the people who accepts the word of God shall be there in heaven, and all the people who violate the word of God and lives in negative attitude of the truth, they shall inherit the everlasting hell. What is there in hell? It is a place which is burning with flames. It cannot be quenched. So all the people shall be there with gnashing of teeth and crying. It is the most dangerous place. There is no end for it, according to the Bible. So, my dear brother and sister, who art thou may be, don't like to follow, don't speak lies. That kind of life has itself become enemy to God. He is always a truth sayer. He loves all the human beings. He himself sacrificed his life on the cross to save them all who comes to him with humble heart. Such people, even though they are filled with such revenge, with no cause, may also be turned into kind heart, kind people, and very soft in their lives. They will have love in their hearts toward every being. So, my dear people, if you want to live in the heaven, please remove hatred in your life. Hatred, whatever it may be. Hatred may be in your life for so many reasons. Whatever the reason may be, you have to remove it from your heart and become a kind and holy person. Such holy thing may be given unto you when you are alive, and the eternal hell may be removed. The hell may be removed for you. That means you need not enter into hell. Why? Because you have become a child of God with all loving kindness and holiness. Praise the Lord. I take leave in the name of Lord Jesus. I pray for you. If you do believe these words that are given to you by the Holy Spirit, you may be saved and inherit the everlasting life to spend with the living God. Thank you all. Praise the Lord. If you want prayer help, please call on 970-533-7645. Let us pray. Our beloved Father, I thank Thee for Thy loving kindness. Thou hast given Thy word. Father, let every human being may transform in their lives and remove the enmity and hatred and all sorts of sin from their lives, and fill with Thy kindness, with Thy love, with Thy purity and love and holiness. Father, remember us to accept as Thy children, asking in the name of Holy Spirit, in the name of Jesus. Amen.